Hello, I'm Jeff Zack, the president of Z Supply in Muskegon, Michigan, where we manufacture EasyFlex, the best value in underground supply for outdoor wood boilers. I'm here today to talk about our value as pertains to the style of product that we make. What I'm referring to is the wrapped style of product that has a radiant barrier on the outside of it. There are several manufacturers of this product. Some of them use a product like this that has a polypropylene, several layers of polypropylene, and some of them have a foil foam foil product like this that is a standard polyethylene product. In either case, these products are wrapped around the PEX inside and then put inside of an outer casing such as the one that we use. The reason I'm here today is because it's become apparent to me from a review of some of the websites that are out there of the manufacturers and resellers of this type of wrap product that there are some deep misconceptions or misunderstandings about our values pertaining to these products. For an example, one manufacturer's website that I visited, a company that has both a 3-wrap and a 5-wrap, touts an R value of 33. They make the point that the base insulation has an R value of 11. And so you take that times 3 for their triple wrap product, and that gives their product an R value of 33. Another reseller's website that I noted that has the other style of product that I mentioned, the polypropylene style product, claims that they have an R value of between 14 and 16. Now, in either case, these R values are really amazing if they're true. So let's take a look at how those R values are obtained by the base product, the foam product itself, before it goes into the wrap product, and then we'll see if those R values can transfer from that product to this product. Now, first I'd like to say that, and get this out of the way really quickly, that the manufacturers of these products obtain their R values in a reasonable way for their industry. These companies, this one out east and this one in the Midwest, are both companies with great reputations. They're substantial companies, and their products work very well in the applications for which they're intended. First, let's examine how the manufacturers of the foil foam foil products get the R value that they use for their products. In every case, those R values are the result of using the insulation within a system. In this example, the system is a 2x4 construction. Sometimes it's a 2x6 construction or even a 2x10 construction. But this example will be just simply a 2x4 construction. So they place the radiant barrier material, the foil foam foam material, in the middle of this cavity. And then they apply a 3/4 inch board on one side, and on the other side perhaps another 3/4 inch board, or maybe a piece of drywall. And then this entire construction is measured, and that's how they get the R value. Now, the R value may be measured down, sideways, or once again they get a up number. And that number could be R11 for down or higher, R7 perhaps, or R8 for the side, and maybe an R5 or 4 when they do the R value up. Now, once again, for these manufacturers, this is a perfectly legitimate way for them to measure their R values for their products, which are used in the construction industry. But let's see if these R values in this product can then be transferred from the construction industry to the pipe business. Okay. Now that we have an understanding of how the manufacturers of the radiant barrier products come up with an R value for their products, let's see if that R value can apply toward the products that we manufacture and the others manufacture that use a wrap style of the radiant barrier around the PEX. First of all, let's try this. Obviously, it's not going to fit. In fact, if you think about it, if we were going to get an R value of 11 all around these two pieces of PEX with this product, we'd have to have a 5-inch construction, the two 1⅛-inch OD pieces of PEX, and another 5-inch construction for a total of over 11 inches. Now, if you wanted to get an R33, how would you do that? Well, you'd have to have this times 3 for 15 inches, and then another 15 inches on the other side of the PEX for a total system of over 30 inches. It's obvious then, if you think about it, that there's no way that the wrap style products can have an R33 inside of a 4-inch casing. Okay, so we've addressed the misconception that the R values obtained by the radiant barrier manufacturers in their systems can be applied toward insulated pipe. It just can't work. Another misconception out there is that the more radiant barriers you have, the better your product is going to be. And that's not true either. In fact, this was addressed by the RIMA website. That's the Radiant Barrier Insulation Manufacturers Association. There's a question there that asks, if we have multiple radiant barriers, does it multiply the effect of the radiant material? And the answer is no. Here's why. Because there must be a airspace on the outside of the radiant barrier for it to be effective. That's why we and the other manufacturers all have an airspace on the outside of our product. Because without this airspace on the outside of the insulated pipes, the radiant barrier is no longer effective. There absolutely must be an airspace on one side or the other of the radiant barrier for it to be effective. Now, as you can see, in these wrap products, in our product and any other, there is no airspace between the radiant barriers. Where there's no airspace, where there's another object touching the radiant barrier, it's not a radiant barrier anymore, it's just another conductor of radiant energy. It just does not work. So, am I saying that wrapped products like ours are not effective, that they don't perform well? Absolutely not. Our product, EasyFlex, performs extremely well. We did temp loss testing on our product in January of 2012, and we were very, very pleased with the results. In fact, we found that under a load of 63,500 BTUs and at 5 gallons per minute, we lost less than 1 degree per 100 foot with EasyFlex. In fact, the number was 0.87 degrees per 100 foot. Now, these tests were done at the steady state. They're the average of 3 readings for each test, and we had a contractor do it in a situation where we really had no say about the results except for delivering, of course, a quality product. Now, temp loss testing is a much more valid way of determining whether or not these products work than our values that really do not apply from one industry to another. Okay, while we're on the subject of R values, let's talk about the R value claims of some other manufactured products that are available in the marketplace. And this is one of them I'd like to talk about. The manufacturer of this product claims an R value of 25. Well, that'd be pretty good. But standard polyethylene insulation, which is what this is made with, really only has an R value of around 3. Now, R value of our silver foam insulation, which we use to make EasyFlex, has about a 40% advantage over that. So per inch of silver foam insulation, we have an R value of about 4.26. Let's go back to this product again. In order to get the R value of 25, they have to go across the entire dimension of the product. So they get an R value of 25 by measuring all the way across. That doesn't seem like an appropriate way to measure R value to me, but you can decide that. Now, finally, let's talk about one manufacturer that is extremely honest about their R values, and that's Watts. And I just want to say hooray to Watts for being extremely honest and forthright about how about the R values in their products. This is Watts R-Flex. Now, Watts only claims an R value of 3.8 for this product, and that's probably very accurate because they're measuring the R value from the side of the PEX through their standard polyethylene foam over to the edge of their product. Hooray for Watts. They've done it right. They're a company of integrity. This is Jeff Zak for Z Supply. Thank you for your time.